The request, or the request of the ministry, and the concern over 405, and I reviewed the response from Jenna Barr, and then I reviewed everything else, and we know that the upper aquitard is divided into two sections. There's the fractured, or weathered zone, and then there's the unfractured. And that's where it moves very slowly, 10 dimes, half an inch a year. So when I look at all this, I don't really believe what what Jenna Barr is saying, that by taking the water or lessening the pressure in the confined aquifer, they're saying it can have an effect on the upper aquitard. It only moves through this layer at half an inch a year. If we look at all the documents that are being presented to us, we know that the upper aquitard was influenced greatly within days. There's only one way that could happen. There has to be a connection between the upper aquitard and the confined aquifer. And so I worked with two different independent universities. Both said the same thing. There is a connection between them. And so we have two independent people who are just looking at all the information that's been provided. We have a fellow by the name of, Jager Hems, owned by Jenna Barr, who's protecting themselves. They're going to make sure this is going to work. I've asked over and over in the tri-party meetings as well, which are being widely quoted, that Jager Hems would produce how they figured it out. Well, that's still outstanding. And it's right in the tri-party meetings. It's explained very clearly that Jager couldn't do this. It's never been done. The best that we got at this table was a quote for $35,000 to come up with some other way of finding the answer. So we can't have any confidence. This committee cannot have any confidence in what Jenna Barr is saying right here. Unless somebody can figure out the magic of the water falling meters and meters when it's only supposed to move at half an inch a year. So I don't take any solace in this. And I go back to in the beginning of when this committee wanted to understand better about the calibrated module. And we hired David Charlesworth, a doctor, a hydrogeologist, to help us understand. And he said the calibrated modeling was fundamentally flawed. That's what he said. And so that's why we started on this journey of trying to get the calibrated module, which has turned into just a trip, which goes on and on. And so because the 39 reference points that Gord is sharing with us, all of those numbers are fictitious. They're just nothing. And they're average numbers. And so when the water's lower, it's lower. And so to look at that, it tells us that there's times, if we believe that it's accurate, the average is right level. So there have to be times it's lower. That's a fundamental flaw, and it's a violation of the certificate of approval. Those of us who study this, and we know that the C of A should have been torn off immediately. However, the Ministry of the Environment is holding stay, and they're going to protect the position of the county and Jager Hems for as long as they can. We have to remember that even Jager Hems is under investigation by its own body, and I seen that in the order, and I thought, what's that about? So I phoned up the professional engineers, and I said, can I make a complaint too? And they said, no, Mr. Hawkins, you can't do that. Only a professional engineer can complain about another professional engineer. So we now know by the order that was put up by the IPC that Jager Hems is being investigated because he's not doing, they're suspicious of his actions. So don't feel bad at this table, we're feeling a little bit suspicious. People who have degrees and rings are feeling the same way. I have a whole bunch of stuff in this, but I think that's enough. I just don't think this committee should, run away and think we can believe this stuff. I was in that hole. If we believe the numbers, I should have had a snorkel on. know, like, there's something definitely wrong here, and I don't think we have to really talk anymore about it other than, you know, like, I want to wait and see what the ministry's new person, the new one again, somebody's got to, they have to retrain, and I think Greg has often pointed out it takes a while for people to learn at the ministry, to then go back over their response and see what they're going to say this time. But at the end of the day, we can't believe they're not credible.
With all due respect, Steve, the person who's going to be looking at this is likely the most senior hydrogeologist in the ministry of the department. He doesn't have to learn anything. He's got years of experience.
I'm happy to hear that. It's just that, as a member of the CMC, you know, it's been like a game. We've had people sitting here that have come, they've been transferred out, they've retired, they've all promised things. Even Cindy Hood has come and promised. And you know what? Every time, it's pure disappointment. Even the minister Garrison has promised us not an answer. He said that we would handle all these issues at this table in an email to our then chair.
If you get an answer, if you don't like the answer, that doesn't mean you didn't get an answer. If you get an answer that 4.5 is acceptable, which is what the response from Director Hemmings is February 11th, and the ministry reviews it, and the ministry accepts their comments, then 4.5 is acceptable. I'll defer to the hydrogeologists who are looking at it. They've got years of experience. They've got years of training in this field. And I don't think any of us have that.
Well, the people I hired taught all your people. So I'm going to be interested to see.
Well, I think this one can wait.
Absolutely. Yeah. I'm for it.
But at the same time, you know, we still have the right to pursue it. Question it and tie it into your research in the future. Let's wait for this point for a response for next month and go from there.
I just think we have to be wary as a committee. We don't let this one go.
No.
Because the county has stated very clearly they need to keep that C of A to maintain their direction. That's us. And so it would be really nice to know what that direction is. Thank you.